to remove the axle, it is needed to remove this big nut. This is something 32 millimeter. Yeah, 32 millimeter. So for this purpose, what I have to do is I have to open the lock for the nut, because it is locked over here using a small screwdriver. I did it, I opened it. Now I have to put the 32 millimeter socket, and of course the breaking bar. It needs lot of force to open it. We're breaking the vehicle proper way so that it should not move. Broke open. It is still very hard to open. Now we are going to make a little bit lubrication on using my WD-40. I have to make a little bit lubrication so that it will come easily. Now loosen. What we will have to do is we have to check the vehicle, and then we will remove the four nuts, the wheel, and then we will do the further process. So what we did is I removed this big nut from the axle, and now I will have to open these two bolts, which are 19 millimeter head, to make it free the wheel. I already made them loose. So both are removed. Both pins also removed. So by this way, I have to remove the axle from so the axle come off from the hub. Now we will pry it from the inside. I will have to show you the procedure from the inside also, how to make it pry. It's a bit difficult to crawl underneath the vehicle, but I will try to do it to show it on the camera. Here is what is the location. You can see the oil is dropping from the transmission, and this axle is actually in the transmission. Over here I did pry it. Here in this location I did pry it with the hammer off, with the help of hammer and a screwdriver. So now you can see this axle, this whole axle which is in my hand, is coming off. Showing over here is a bit difficult, but what I did, I have to put a pan over here to collect the oil so that the oil should not contaminate the road. Here is the axle coming off in two parts from the car. As you can see, this is the rubber boot, contaminated and very badly. You can say this is torn out and broken. Two parts, two pieces. Here is a new one. You can see this is one piece. It will go like this. So what we will do is we will have to remove this bearing actually. This three tripod bearing we will have to remove. Here is the snap ring for this. The snap ring we will remove and then pry the bearing off. We'll clean it and then fix this, and then I'll put it off. Put it on the new one. The existing one we will clean after cleaning. I will show the procedure. Some people are a bit anal. What they are going to do is they are putting it with the bearing, but this is not the proper way. And of course I'm not an anal, so what I'm going to do is I will put it in the proper way. So what we are going to do is, now we are going to slip this new boot rubber on the existing axle. So by this way, now it reached. So what we will do is we will put the clip. This is what is the metal clip for the boot. Make it straight using my pliers. So we are reusing it actually. We have new, but the same one I'm going to put it on. So by this way, I have to make it as a ring, and then again. Here is the lock. So what I will do is I will have to grip it properly and then put on the lock. Little bit hammering is required. So by this way, and then return it back through this way so that it will not come off. This boot rubber is on, the clip is on also. So what we will do is we will put the other end, but first we will have to put the bearing on. Bearing we are going to make it grease, proper way lubricated, because it is needed. And what I can do is I will have to put a little bit of grease inside so that it will lubricate in future. Not too much, but little bit is okay, and this will prevent the axle from moisture also. Moisture and dust will not enter by this way, as lubrication is there inside. Applying through finger. This is actually the general purpose lithium based grease which I am using for this purpose. Gray is also coming, black is also coming. All are okay, all are working. But the key is you must have to remove the old lubrication. Old grease should not be there as much as you can. So by this way we are going to repack it. So now it's okay. So here is the bearing, already lubricated. So I'm going to put it on the shaft. A little bit hammering is required here. So little tap will do, like this. What I have to do is I have to put the snap ring, the lock on. For this purpose, I will need the snap ring tool. I will hold it. Hold it like this and then put a force on the tool and put the snap ring on by this way. Removing the tool and then making a little bit tap on. So by this way it's okay. Now what I have to do is I have to put little more lubrication on the bearings. So this is enough. And here in the metal piece of the other half also, I have to put lubrication in. So now you can see enough quantity of lubrication is there inside the half of the axle. So now we have to fix both half. But this way, we'll create a little bit hydraulic on, because lubrication is there, so the extra lubrication will come off. But it needs a little bit force to do the job. We will wipe off the remaining grease from something extra. Here underneath this one is a place for the axle, so the axle will go in the transmission over here. As you can see, the hole is over there from where the oil is dripping. So this is, so here you can see the axle. Now we put the rubber on and locked all everything, so axle is now ready to go in the car. So what I will have to do is I will have to put the axle on the car. I'm going to show. From here we can take the axle by this way. We'll throw it and then we'll hammer it from here. Now it had been seated, so by this way we have to. And now what we will do is we will have to fix it inside the hub. So this is the way. As I removed it, from the hub. So the axle, again we will put it in hub and we'll tighten each and everything. So this is what is our axle job.